and everyone. How's everybody doing on this great blessed day that God has blessed us with, people? Back at it again with another vlog. Video vlog, what, part 46? Getting there, man, getting there. I figure I'll redo this vlog because the other one that I did yesterday was too raw, too sketchy. Figure I'll start off new. Want to give you 5 steps into finding that significant other. 5 steps. Make sure you follow with me. But first, I'm giving you from my personal perspective. It's going to be from my personal perspective. Yes, I've been with women that have used me for money. Yes, I've been with women that used me to get a roof over their head. See what else? Yes, I've been used by women who've used me for materialistic needs or mutual gain. I've been through the whole 9, just like anybody else has, so don't fault nobody for I've been the same boat you have. Truth be told, I got a story that's... This happened back in 2006, I was in Hawaii. Me and this girl supposed to go on a date to the movies now. She riding with me now. We're going to the movies. I'm buying both of our tickets. Not knowing that she meeting a guy up there on a date to see him. So basically, she took the ticket that I bought her. She took her ticket and went and met dude, and they went to the movies together, and that left me high and dry. I had to watch the movie by myself. Y'all know, right? It's a slap in the face.
Here you go. Yeah, I'm tired. That was so disrespectful. You gonna hit me in my mouth?
You know, it's just one of the stories. I got way more stories than that. Like, this is nothing compared to what I used to go through, but healthy skin. But let's
go to step one.
Make sure you follow signs that God shows you. You know, same thing that for the person that you're chasing. Make sure you watch the signs that God shows you, because when he puts someone in your corner for a reason, that's him saying that that's the potential right person for you. But the people that like constantly chasing after other people, like, don't do that. Man, quit chasing after women. Women, quit chasing after man. You know, just be in their corner. You know, start off first, nice and slow. Like, and pay attention to the signs that God shows you each and every time. You'd be surprised at the results, but you have to be patient. You have to pay attention, you know? A lot of people don't see the signs. You know, it's there, point blank. Like, if God puts a person in your corner for a reason, and they are always there for you hand to foot, then, you know, that's a potential match. Okay, next.
Step two.
We finna get in the friend zone. That's right. If you hear a line saying, oh, I've been in so many bad relationships, oh, I just want friends right now. They friend zoned you. Basically, I'm gonna put it in layman terms that you can understand. I'm gonna break it down in layman terms. Yes, they want a relationship, but they don't want it with you. You know, God never steers us wrong. You know, I've been through so much. Like I said, I'm 34 years old. I've been through a lot, I've seen a lot, and I know what I'm talking about. If you get friend zoned, that means they saying, like, I only want you as a friend, nothing more. This how it is. Because truth be told, I have so many. If I was to sit up here and tell you how many women that's on my friend list on social media that have friend zoned me, we'll be here all day long. All day. And I don't have that kind of time in the world. So, you know, just be careful. You know, be careful of the friend zone for all you wonderful people out there.
Step three.
If you fully give yourself to a person publicly and privately, meaning you're giving it your all, but not only that, if y'all somehow make love, give your body to a person, and like you thinking you're gonna be in a relationship the next day and they still keep you in that friend zone, like that's a red flag. Because the reason I say it's a red flag, because like our bodies are like the temple of Christ. You know, I don't just give my body to anyone. You know, And if you give your body to that person, you expecting their relationship, and they expect they still want a friend zone you, that's a red flag. You know, just take it steady. You know, only time will tell. Because I can guarantee you, when you making love to a person, like, your feelings, like, digs deep, way deep than what you, like, had before. Like, you had deep feelings for that person, but once y'all make love, the feelings get deeper. And, like, I don't see how many people can have multiple sleeping partners. I just don't see it. Like, if you make love to that person, if you give your body to that person, you know, make that person your top priority. Don't go around sleeping with this person, then sleep with the next person, when you know that person over there got feelings for you, and you sleeping with this person, you sleeping with that person to have a good time. The reason I say that, because in my early, I don't do it no more, but in my early 20s to mid 20s to late 20s, I've used women for materialistic stuff, for mutual gain. I've used them for their bodies. You know, I didn't know it hurt them like that until it happened to me. And, like, that truly hurts. It hurts a lot, you know. I just want to tell people to be really careful. Be cautious of your surroundings and what you do towards that person you care about. You know, I know a lot of people don't want to get hurt or whatnot. You know, just take it easy. You know what I mean? Okay, let's get on
to the next step. Step four.
If you're doing step four, if you are doing all the contacting, meaning if you're doing all the calling and all the texting, and the only way they're responding is if they text you, and that's another red flag. You know, you have to be careful in that. You know, I'm not saying stop texting or calling them completely. I'm not saying it at all. I'm saying, like, ease up on it a little bit, you know, just to see if that person care about you. You know, because if you giving all your time towards that person and they not showing it back, then you might have to back off a little bit. But yeah, just try to take it easy as much as possible, man. You know, protect your feelings, protect your heart by any means necessary. You know,
the last and final step, step five.
Be patient with God. I don't stress that enough. Go all the way back to step one. Follow the signs that God gives you, and all the way up to step five, be patient with God. Like I said, when I say ease up on the texting, like I said, if he ordained y'all to be together, trust me, he gonna reunite y'all. He gonna reunite y'all together again. I can promise you that. God never fails in his signs, you know. But if he doesn't reunite y'all together somehow, then, you know, he gonna bless you with somebody better than the person you was chasing. You know, that's the best advice I can give you. You know, I know a lot of people don't want to hear. I know that
they're gonna be like, but I love that person. I really do care about that person.
You know, that you gotta look at it. Did God ordain that person for you? Did he ordain that person for you? You gotta answer that question, because he come first. He's the center of your life. He's the center of my life. You know, I'm nothing without Jesus. I wouldn't have made it this far in life without Jesus. You know, you have to keep your head up. You have to keep going, stay ahead of the race, you know. But like I said, like, I'm throwing the gauntlet down. If I'm wasting time, or if, like, you don't think I deserve to be by your side, then let me know, because I know my worth. You know, God knows my heart. You know, a lot of people out here want to continue friend zoning people, and, like, I just don't have the time and patience to keep me in friend zone. Like, I'm a king looking for a queen. If that sounds right, a king looking for a queen. You know, every woman I've ever met or been with or been around, I've treated them all like queens, like nothing less. And that's the golden standard of how a man's supposed to treat a woman. You're supposed to treat them like a queen and nothing less, with love and respect. You love them, respect them, you know. But again, man, stop chasing after these women. God will bless you with the right woman. I can guarantee you, if you put that person in your corner for a reason, you know, take the sign. Women, stop chasing after these men. God will bless you with the right man. You know, if you put that person in your corner for a reason, take it, you know. And I don't say that enough. Like, if he puts a person in your corner for a reason, take that chance. You know, you've been in a lot of bad relationships, that's him saying, well, I'm trying to give you the right one, but are you going to listen to me? Are you going to pay attention to the signs? Because many people don't pay attention to the signs. They too self-centered and so focused and caught up in this world rather than him blessing you with the right person. So pay attention to the signs, man, you know? Especially if the person is a good Christian person, a God-fearing Christian at that, you know? They worship God like no other. They put God first in their life like no other. Like that person, that's the person you need to have, you know? I just wish I had a person that always got my back handed feet like I've had, like most women, man. Because boy, if you met me and know me, I go all out with my heart on my sleeve. I go all out. When I love you to the fullest extent. I give you my all, you know, nothing less, you know. I spoil deep level. Ladies and gentlemen, I have stories. I have stories for days, but I'm not going to get into that. You know, I figure I give y'all my advice. You know, I'm not stepping on anybody's toes because people don't take this video the wrong way. Just know I'm trying to protect your feelings and your heart and your emotions. You know, if you're going to give yourself to that person physically, mentally, and emotionally, then y'all should take that chance. You know, don't be trying to play Russian roulette with people's feelings, because that's a slap in the face.
You hit me in my mouth.
Slap me in my face with some money. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's the best advice I can give y'all, man. If you follow these steps, you know, you'll get along just fine. Everything's gonna be all right. I can promise you that. You know, you're gonna still have God in your corner. He's gonna guide you through the whole situation, you know. But that's all the time I got for y'all today. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell on all up-to-date entertainment, game, and video blog news that I bring all you beautiful people around the world. You name it, I bring it. And thank y'all from the bottom of my heart. Like I said, throughout all like the negative and positive feedback that I be getting daily, you know, I put everything I have into these videos as a positive reason, because I want to give to you all, like, my advice from my personal perspective, you know. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. I promise to be as real as possible, you know, to cling on to you all understanding. But not my understanding, you know, cling to God's understanding, not to your own, you know. Just keep your head up and be simple-minded. Well, I ain't going to say simple-minded. I want to say optimistic. If I might say, be optimistic, just keep your head up, you know, keep your head above water. But yeah, man, until then, y'all take it easy, and don't forget to get right with Jesus. Peace. I'm out.